Welcome, welcome, replay viewers. This is Julie Jordan Scott. I am so glad that you are here. Great music from Ellie Fordyce is filling here. I hope you can hear her about to start singing. Focus for today. We're going to be talking literary travel. Part of the September Scopers Challenge is about travel, and I missed yesterday, so I'm delighted to be here. Let me turn her off. Sorry, Ellie. I'm actually in Fresno, California, outside of Bakersfield, which is where I usually hang out. Good morning. And I'm delighted to be here to talk to you about literary travel. I am a big time road tripper, which is great because I'm in my car. I love to road trip, especially to visit literary spots. Hey, Porterville buddy. I'm in Fresno, usually in Bakersfield, so good to see you. But anyway, literary travel can even happen here in the Central Valley of California. But this summer, I did some traveling around the United States, and I wanted to share with you some of those spots. And I also want to talk to you about building literary travel or travel for yourself into travel with your family. Because when I travel, I like to have separate goals and intentions for each person in the group. So this summer, we went to the Pacific Northwest on a road trip, and Samuel, my 10-year-old, loves Nintendo. So we actually visited Nintendo headquarters, which was really exciting for him and exciting for me to see how much he loved it. But within that traveling, we went and saw some literary spots. Did you know, for example, that Beverly Cleary, if you've ever read her books, she is from Portland. And so on our way to Seattle, we stopped in Portland where they had sculptures from Beverly Cleary's characters that they turned into a spray park, which was awesome. So the kids can enjoy the spray park and I can enjoy being amongst my literary granny and a hero of mine. So that was really cool to see Henry Higgins and Beezus and a dog. I didn't know there was a dog in Beverly Cleary books, but it was thrilling to be there. Another thing that we did is to find some literary grannies by accident while we were in the Pacific Northwest. One of the great things about traveling is you can find stuff that you don't even know is there when you start. And so I found some great things. I'm always open. And that's another great thing about traveling, is to always be open to what might be there that you hadn't known was there before. So right there on Vashon Island in Washington, I discovered Betty McDonald. Do you know who Betty McDonald is? She is the writer who created Miss Pigglewiggle. Do you all know who Miss Pigglewiggle is? Or she's just phenomenal. I love her. I started reading her. I didn't even know who she was. Hi, Sheila Wild. Thanks for joining me. We're talking about literary grannies and travel. The ironic thing is my friend just said, have you ever heard of that book, The Egg and I? And I said, no, I've never heard about The Egg and I. And she's not into the literary grannies. So I was like, oh my gosh, Betty McDonald. She was an incredible memoir writer. She wrote children's books. And I have discovered and fallen in love with her. So that when I went to Portland to see Beverly Cleary, I built in a visit to Powell Books where I could buy some books by Betty McDonald with The Egg and I. When you have a passion like I do for writers and books, what a great thing to do to build it into your trips. So my friend is taking me to see Bainbridge Island, which I really enjoyed, and lo and behold, along the way there's Vashon Island, which is where Betty McDonald was from. And in Portland, I could hang out with my friend and her children at a spot that's Beverly Cleary inspired and a place for the kids to play. These places really aren't hard to find either. In fact, I was on a Twitter chat one day and I was talking about what literary things you have in your town. Most people don't know. And I can find them really easily. One that I found this summer, again on road tripping, was, yeah, it really is fun. I was road tripping to Bishop, and I was purposely trying not to do the quirky things that I like to do, which is like go to cemeteries and go off the beaten path and check out dilapidated buildings to take photos. I didn't do that. I was like, look, family, I'm trying to be normal. But I saw a sign that said Mary Austin Home. So on the way back, after everyone had their fun, I decided I wanted to check out that historical marker. Little did I know that Mary Hunter Austin is a significant woman writer from the early 20th century. What a find! She wrote Land of Little Rain, which was listed as one of the top nature books of the 20th century. And not only that, she has ties to Kern County, which is where we live. Not far from Porterville and Fresno. I know we're out of water, but we have cool writers here. She's just remarkable. I've blogged about her. You can find me, Julie Jordan Scott. You probably might want to Google me because I'm in the midst of transition from one blog to another. So if you Google Julie Jordan Scott, you can find my blog, you can find my Twitter, you can find just about every place I hang out and connect with me there. But anyway, Mary Hunter Austin talks about the Land of Little Rain, and she mentioned a place called Las Uvas. And I'm like, Las Uvas? The grapevine? Sure enough, now this is really a surprise. She and her family owned property in Bakersfield during 1880 to like 1880s. And she taught for ranchers in Las Uvas, which is a town that no longer exists. I mean, it exists, but it's basically a rest stop off the Interstate 5. You might have been there if you've driven from San Francisco to LA. You've probably passed, just didn't know. So my friend and I went exploring, and guess what we found? We found the foundation for the ranch where she most likely had taught when she was, you know, 21 years old, before she became Mary Hunter Austin, the writer. Now, this is the kind of find that just thrills me, and you can find so close to your home. And if you don't know that they exist, just open up and think, what's my passion? What do I love? I love writing. I love books. I love women writers. I kind of created this whole literary granny thing. It really turns me on, as you can hear. So no matter where you are. As a matter of fact, if you'd like to find out more about literary grannies or writers in your area, tweet me at Julie Jordan Scott. Say, I would like to know about writers here in whatever town you're in. Porterville, I've just told you a couple. They're close to us. Literally any city, I guarantee I could find someone for you to research and to fall in love with. Because it's so fun to fall in love with writers and writing. It's so inspiring. So thank you. Thank you for your compliments. I JulieJordanScott. Find me on Twitter. Tweet me. Ask me questions. And just I hope this was inspiring. I'm so glad that you were here to listen. For listening. Thank you for having me. It's a delight. Cover Scopers rock. Check it out. Hashtag. Is turn. Recall.